This place is so big and so massive that my brain can't even understand the scale and the size. 10 years ago, I was driving across country and I had this magical idea of what that trip was gonna be like. And I was gonna stop at all these sites and do historic Route 66 and it was gonna be awesome. And the trip ended up being nothing like that. I was rushing to get from one end of the country to another, didn't have time to see all the sites I wanted to, and my biggest regret was not seeing Grand Canyon. So here I am now back in Arizona. I'm here for a psychology conference. I was down in Tucson and I told everyone I'm gonna be gone for a couple of days so I can drive up and see the Grand Canyon because I didn't want to miss it again. That's the thing about regret, when your reality is very close to this imagined thing that you want to see happen and you don't do it, you regret stuff even more. That's why I spent hours driving hundreds of miles so I could come here and see the canyon. So this got me thinking, why do so many people all over the world travel so far to experience nature? Biologist Edward Wilson said it's because we have a biophilia, a love of life, love of nature and animals, and it's hardwired in us because we evolved out here. We have a natural love of it, an affinity for it. We want to be out here. There does seem to be something about nature that's hardwired in us. People just seem to do better after they've had some exposure to nature. Your cognitive abilities are actually better after exposure to the outdoors. Kids perform better after spending time in recess outdoors. And here's the most interesting thing. People after surgery and after some type of major medical procedure tend to recover better if they have a window that exposes them to the outdoors. It doesn't even have to be real. Just seeing a photograph of the outdoors versus a photograph of an urban environment leads people to recover faster and better from surgeries. So what is it about nature that helps us to think more clearly, feel more calm, and act in such a peaceful way? Part of it is the peace and quiet. You don't have all the sounds, the sirens, and noises that you usually have in a city. And if you work in an open office or live in New York City like I do, you know how much those little sounds can be so distracting and take you away from whatever it is that you're trying to do. Nature also serves a restorative function. When you're in nature, you're not really focused on one thing. And like I talked about in my multitasking episode, it takes a lot of energy for your mind to focus on one idea at one time. In nature, your mind naturally wanders. Ideas bounce around as you're taking in the sights and smells and experiences that are out here. But unfortunately, we're not spending as much time outdoors as we used to. We're spending more and more of it at home with our screens. I think that's one reason why it's hard for a lot of people to be outdoors and they're not really sure what to do and how to stay safe. And others might have allergies or health conditions that make it hard to be outside. You don't have to come all the way here to get the restorative benefits of nature. You can just go to your backyard, your neighborhood park, go for a hike nearby your home. Being out here in Grand Canyon makes me feel so small in comparison to this massive place. But I'm also reminded of how special it is that we, as humans, exist. Maybe that's why we love nature. It reminds us of how amazing life is. How do you experience nature in your day-to-day life? Let me know in the comments below. I'm at Ali Matu on social media. Be sure to like The Psych Show on Facebook and subscribe on YouTube. This old Vistaport reminds me of the Millennium Falcon.